Unpaid child support. It's a $1 billion problem in Pennsylvania. In fact, in Allegheny County alone, 38,000 deadbeat parents owe more than $130 million.
Well, now a Team 4 investigation is taking action for you, tracking down what is being done about going after these deadbeats.
Here's investigative reporter Jim Parsons.
Now, Wendy and Andrew, here's a new tool that won't be popular with a lot of deadbeat parents this time of year. For the first time, Pennsylvania is seizing hunting licenses if you owe back child support. And how about a new system for seizing gambling winnings at Pennsylvania casinos or royalty checks from landowners with Marcellus Shale gas wells? Those new methods of collecting are all on the way in an aggressive campaign to collect support. Some say, though, it's too aggressive, and others say it isn't aggressive enough.
I think it's crazy. I think it's unfair. I think it's unjustified, to be honest with you.
Pat McConville never had a problem making child support payments. Not until UPMC Braddock shut down last year and he lost his maintenance job there. Then Pat missed several payments, but still owed less than $900 in back support when he learned something last summer that took him off guard.
I called the bank to try to restructure my finances. Then they called me back and they says you have a lien on your property. And I go, well, who put a lien on it? And they go, well, Allegheny County Domestic Relations.
That's right. Pat had a lien on his house in West Mifflin for a grand total of $819.63.
Didn't know nothing about it, never got nothing in the mail, no phone call, no nothing.
It's nothing we even touch. It's done by operation of law, and it's automatic.
Patrick Quinn is the man in charge of child support enforcement in Allegheny County.
This thing is driven by the computer in the law. So if you don't make your payment in a timely manner and you miss by 10 days, all of these remedies are going to kick in on your case.
Besides property liens, those automatic remedies are supposed to include income attachments, intercepts of tax returns and unemployment checks, credit bureau reporting, passport denial, and driver's license suspension. But Judy Siegel thinks the system failed her.
How much does he owe you?
$146,000.
Judy's ex-husband still owes her $146,000 from non-payment of child support. But he has kept his driver's license and, in fact, is in compliance now. How is that possible?
If they owe $100,000 and they owe a driver and they still have their driver's license, they are complying with a court order. They are complying with a payment plan with the court.
That's exactly what's happening with Judy's ex-husband. He didn't want to speak with Team 4 on camera, but tells us he filed a motion with the court to have his support payments reduced from $1,600 a month to $470, and the court agreed based on a change in his income.
He says he doesn't have it. He doesn't have any money. And he throws his hands up in the air, and he says, I don't have it. I just don't have it anymore.
How long would it take for you to get what is owed to you at $470 a month?
25 years.
Judy may be frustrated, but her ex-husband says the system is working since he's now making payments that he can afford.
If you've lost your job, if you have a different job, you're making less money. We want you to come in. We want to enter realistic orders. We always want to reach out to people, particularly in these trying economic times.
And Quinn has some numbers to show his office is reaching out and collecting. In 2008, his office collected 77% of the support that was owed. Last year, that increased to almost 82%, the highest rate of any comparably sized county, according to one study. But his collection employees also have the lowest caseload, half the size of other cities, thanks to an annual $1 million grant from the state that started 5 years ago. And there is still room for improvement in the non-automatic collection methods. Our Team 4 analysis reveals the number of times family court used financial seizures to collect child support was down in the first half of 2010 from the same period the year before. So were seizures of court settlements and judgments, and professional licenses were seized only 61 times in 18 months. And the most nagging problem still hasn't gone away.
If the person that owes all the money owns all of his assets in someone else's name or jointly with another person, oftentimes you can't get at those assets.
But Pat Quinn says his office is doing better now than ever before.
I'm a big believer in the word on the street, that the word gets spread about that, hey, Allegheny County, they will catch up with you.
But not for everybody.
We do have lots more information on our website about all of the tools parents can use to fight for the support owed to their children. Just go to thepittsburghchannel.com and click on the Team 4 page. And you'll also find a link there to a searchable website where you can find out exactly how much each deadbeat parent owes, case by case across the state, and what steps have already been taken or not taken, for that case, to collect. You can search it by name, anybody in the state. All you have to do is sign up, and it's free to join. And you can find any case, how much somebody owes, and what the court's been doing about it. Mm.
That is a great addition to our website.
Yes, it is.
These
are great tools that people can use right now, tonight, to find out what's been done and what else they can do to collect.
ThePittsburghChannel.com. All right.
Team 4 page.
Thanks,
there you
Jim.
Go.
Okay.